This isn't a movie special effect, but footage of actual laborers. 300,000 Chinese spend 10 years carving this canal through a mountainside. One man documented the construction from start to finish in a film called Red Flag Canal. Premier Zhou Enlai often said New China had two wonders. First was the Nanjing Yangtze River Bridge, and second was the Red Flag Canal. In spring of 1969, director Jiang Yun-chuan of the Central Newsreel and Documentary Film Studio was handed the order to film the canal's construction.
半夜一点多钟，大概是，把我叫到这个，新营84幺最高头的老苏的办公室。他说要让我去拍片子，但我现在不能去，为什么不能去？我顶着黑帮帽子，我六次抄家，抄的我连个工作证是这全没有。Jiang's
duties were restored on the spot, and he set out that very day. At the time, the Red Flag Canal was only 4 months from completion, but the studio had begun filming 9 years earlier.
原来不叫红旗渠，原来是人民公社办事。
When cameraman Zhao Hua arrived in Lin County to film Long Live the People's Commune in 1960, he was shocked to discover the large-scale canal construction project.
我说黄河之水天上来，现在要把漳河水要也从高山上引到临县来，这简直是奇迹。如果能够实现了，这一定是像神话一样，是吧？As
production on Long Live the People's Commune halted, these men pictured here shouldered the responsibility of filming Red Flag Canal.
1961年、1962年、1963年、1964年、1966年，一直到文化大革命，那个时候每年都要来一次，所以红旗渠呢修了10年，咱们新营在那拍着10年。
This is from the very first film Jiang Yun-chuan produced during his years in the 8th Route Army. Because of his hard work and the fact that he published several articles, he was promoted to work in the Yan'an Film Group. Nearly all of Jiang's early works were rallying cries for the war effort. By 1958, he had completed 3 years of work, filming over 23 documentaries. This film required only 2 days to film and edit. However, Red Flag Canal was an entirely different situation.
红旗渠将要在这些悬崖陡壁上通过。
最长75镜头，你离得太远了就不行，你那稍微近一点。有时候我们找角度爬山，用看角度啊，有时候那个到那个山顶上就那个小心。我得穿布鞋，穿布鞋，一个星期一双鞋。
Filming the blasting scenes required special protective measures.
搭小棚，在那个棚子里头，它那一炸了以后，你知道吗？就是防止我们被那石头砸了。一拍的时候，哗一炸，那么整个那个石头，哗哗就像下雨似的。During
this era, international cinema was experiencing an explosion in cinema verite, which began with the French New Wave.
经过多年风化的悬崖峭壁，常有浮石滚下来伤人，严重的阻碍着工程的进度。共产党员任阳成越是艰险越向前，他带头下悬崖，撬石除险，扫清障碍。
不抛尸，不抛尸，谁不抛尸啊？都抛尸啊！那就是剩，只要这个修了以后，时间长了，就不害怕了，它锻炼出来了。
Each clearing group had three members, one who descended the cliff on a rope, and two others who stayed behind. Ren Yang Cheng had to train new recruits mid-air.
走在悬崖上，空中。这样叫人，你不在空中叫，你在地上，你再做个这个动作，那都不行。还有那个饿也裤子了，下去以后，他害怕，饿到裤子里边了。
Zhang felt that the early footage didn't capture the danger of the work, and needed to be refilmed.
因为这不是悬崖陡壁吗？有一个摄像机。就这么掉下来，那山就这这么拍。有一个呢，站在这个对面的这个三角上，再找个适当的位置，就这么拍。
碰到向里凹进去的险情，就得进行飞崖除险。
The dangers of refilming had lessened after 9 years, but the cameramen used the open air as a background, highlighting the risks involved in the work.Some doubted the authenticity of the footage.
我说叫的可以，你跟那儿下去，我也跟那儿下去。我要是下不去，那我就是叫了。
These shots were taken by Henan Daily journalist Wei Dejong, who spent 10 years documenting the Red Flag Canal's construction. He recalls his first time seeing Ren.
这个棉袄是白花花的一片，就是去倒了一个白絮出来了。这个棉袄脱下来以后，抖了抖，几百个酸枣那个刺。我一想，人家的老姜长在脚上，长在手上；任阳成的老姜长在腰里。
Ren Yang Cheng's achievements were published in school textbooks.Where he was recognized as an exemplary worker.
这里就是一个奖状，一朵花儿。
对，一个奖状当纸，一个红花，还有个宝雪。
The Nanjing Yangtze River Bridge and Red Flag Canal construction periods coincided, but as a symbol of national strength.The bridge was financed by the central government and built with mechanized equipment. The Red Flag Canal's construction depended on Lin County's local workforce. During a 3-year famine beginning in 1960, construction workers had barely enough food to survive, and so work slowed to a crawl.
最开始平均不到一斤，就是几两粮食，六两粮食呀，七两啊，吃树叶儿，挖野菜，去地里那杀杀，不管那草，尝尝苦不苦，说不苦，这个菜好吃，其实都是吃了剩喂剩够那草。
人家工地上的人很照顾我，卖麸子在内，是吧？就是那混合的那个什么那个有那馒头，把那个黄薯秧子。都是那个，就积起来，一吃就酸不溜的，就是那个。
This child's name was Zhang Maijiang. He was 12 when he worked on the construction site.
要到那瓦里头一捞不这个叶菜，这个月亮在上边，就在这个瓦里晃开。我说清到炕，上个炕，帮儿媳妇找月亮。
河里边长那个禾草，全部都吃光了。
As an exemplary worker, Ren Yongcheng could occasionally enjoy a meal of fresh tree leaves on the cliffside.
吃了以后呢，他的壮大部队有卡绳的，他也急啊，修了以后赶快跳开，你快吃，你快吃。
On May 1st, 1960, the celebration for the successful damming of the Upper Canal was marred by an accident.
哎，五一了，是吧？来点炸油饼吧，吃完了以后我们就中毒了。
Zhao Hua kept a journal of his experiences that year.
就觉得我这个脑袋呀特别重，再一睡过去呀，就觉得就会不会醒了。
There wasn't enough cooking oil. So the cook substituted castor oil. Luckily, no one was poisoned to death. During the whole construction process, a total of 81 workers aged 17 to 60 lost their lives. Their average age was 35. After working for 1 month, the technical expert Wu Zutai died in a landslide. And his duties were taken over by farm technician Lu Yin.
贫农社员陆银，破除迷信，解放思想，创造了用水盆代替水平仪的测量方法，测出了那些资产阶级权威们不敢想象的局限，为修渠大军打开了前进的道路。
Zhang Meijiang's father also died on the construction site.
非是拉响，快坐快坐，石头过来了。结果，他光顾了病了，不顾卡上边的。当时买了，就因为不敢叫家那个尸体，砸伤了很惨。
On June 12, 1960, a giant boulder tore loose from the mountain.Crushing 9 workers at the Gudoi Temple worksite.
那个事是，那是我这样撬出来的。那时候感受就是说，人家死了，我给人家穿衣服了，那我要死了，有人给我穿衣服没有啊？
Faced with a heap of bodies, site leader Shi Bingfu broke down and wept.
毛主席指出，中国的妇女是一种伟大的人力资源。临县妇女遵照毛主席的教导，战斗在各个工作岗位上，敢想敢干，苦干加巧干。
分任务不分男女，但是干活是一样的，任务是一样分的，按人头分的。管不成你就加班啊！长时间的和男同志在一起干活，就要拉人家的后腿。我们女同志几个女同志组成一班，组成一个突击队。
贫农社员郭秋英领导的铁姑娘队，为了加速工程进度，以只争朝夕的革命精神下深井赶烟。
我们也是吊着大绳，吊着，对，在底下也没拆，就拆个绳套，在底下。晃晃荡荡的，这时候抓在上边，这脚蹬蹬的一个套，那人可上吊也得。
由于井深洞窄，爆破后浓烟不能马上排出，要是等浓烟自然散去，就得5-6个小时以后才能工作，严重阻碍着工程的进度。因此，
就是我们这个刘树元，他虽然最年轻，他最禁不住的事儿，就这个干的活。他说：“我不行了，我头晕了。”
一天工作12个多小时，晚上12点到中午12点，一天是2班。没有说了过节了，国庆了或者过元旦了，要放假了，这个工期不完成，他们不休工，身体周期不回来。现在我们的女同志一般的情况是都不停。
是3月25号，是吧？我现在写日记。觉得这拿笔的手啊，拿笔的右手啊不大好用。今天因为天阴不能工作，我和老陈上工地去劳动，用了3个多钟头，才打了1尺深，太慢了。直到现在，这只右手 提笔写字都感到不得劲儿。
At first, these women use two hands on their drills. As their experience grew, they used one in each hand, calling it the phoenix spreads its wings. Wei Dejong photographed the scene. The woman in the back row, Qin Rongzhen, is now 77 years old. She still recalls that period of hard labor.
你抬了马，抬了快，给你抄红旗。你要是走了马，你抬了又不马，又走了马，那就是给你插哈旗。这每天这工地上有这广播员，每天是广播你，给你跑一回，算给你一根钳子。你最后给你总结，瞧你顶天抬了几遭。
那时候就是毛泽东思想跑了出来，你挖不成这种主席想给你干嘛？不用我说，我没有说你没有挖成。你跟主席说，我们娘叫我成风高，要不是啊，我们早就也成了这了。成风高，你就不让你插脚这个，我们就这么直接，这么干，也不会上去。
The rheumatism Qin got while working has stayed with her for decades. Qi Meiying, her co-worker, still struggles to keep her fingers closed.
你抓的，他才会跟你的。你要不抓，他就有活头干。没有怨过谁，怨你谁？不怨我。我什么事啊？就是当年你咋还轻手了吧？
No one expected that the original one-year work plan would last 10 years. All of the painstaking labor was put to rest the moment water filled the canal.
This is Mao Zedong's sent to the Xing Hu water. Drink in your mouth, sweet in your heart.
Director Zhang Yun-chuan edited the film alone. He could only work at night during the Cultural Revolution period.
连革命性的打乒乓球你都得去看。本来我有5天，我就可以把这片子干完，结果人家干了1个多月。
On New Year's Day, 1971, Red Flag Canal was released across the nation. The People's Daily printed a 2-page advertisement and published a 4-page review the following week.
爹,
audiences welcomed Red Flag Canal as a break from the drab films and news reports typical of the Cultural Revolution. The film drew attention from around the world. It was shown to US President Nixon during his visit to China, presented before the UN by Chinese leader Deng Xiaoping. The President of Algeria ordered 5 copies to encourage his citizens to work as hard as the Chinese. It is also the sole Chinese documentary mentioned in American film scholar Eric Barnow's A History of the Non-Fiction Film. In 1972, Italian director Michelangelo Antonioni arrived in Linn County to shoot his film China. The canal, however, makes only a brief appearance in his film. Antonioni was more interested in the Chinese people.
Il presidente vorrebbe mostrarci tutto in ordine, vorrebbe spiegare alla sua gente chi siamo, cosa vogliamo. Tutto il tempo che resteremo qui, ai vecchi e alle donne, specie a quelle mal vestite, di nascondersi.
After Zhang Yunchuan retired, he returned to his hobby of writing. Before his 90th birthday, he published his journals, which provide an account of his work on Red Flag Canal. Ren Yangcheng lives in a small house beside the canal, and his home's most precious possession is a wall covered in photographs. Now full of skyscrapers, this former farmland requires less water for irrigation. And the Red Flag Canal has become a tourist spot, earning the city $150 million in revenue annually. There are labor reenactments for visitors to watch. Ren Yangcheng has passed his special skills onto the next generation. Their show by the side of the canal always draws the biggest crowds. Once a lost searching spirit sought to use cinema to summon an age he doubted. This film is the heartfelt soliloquy of an era of doubt and bravery. Please join us for part four of China on Film 2. If you bring up the 1980s, some Chinese might associate the era with great change and youthful vigor. It was an age of dissenting poets and a championship volleyball team. A time when ideals and a lack of direction intertwined. One documentary was able to capture this youthful feeling. In June 1979, the first class of the Central Music Academy excitedly awaited an American music teacher's arrival. Isaac Stern was the first famous violinist to visit China after the Cultural Revolution. He had no concept of what the students had been through.
Music is not black and white.
This Oscar-winning documentary film, From Mao to Mozart, documents Isaac Stern's travels in China. The film's sweeping score and the faces of young, hopeful musicians stirred hearts in the West. And it was on this trip that he uncovered a perplexing question.
That the young people, 8, 9, 10, 11, remarkable. But 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, something happens to them. What happened in between?
Stern was a keen observer. Chinese youth were living in purgatory. In May 1980, the new magazine Chinese Youth printed a letter entitled How are life's roads getting narrower? The letter incited a conversation amongst its youthful readership. That year, a documentary seeking to answer this question began production. During Stern's visit, Central Academy of Music pupil Xiao Dan became a focus of the film. Ten youth with similar experiences became the focus of Don't Let Time Slip Through Your Fingers. The film created waves among China's younger generation. 30 years later, Fudan University graduate Pan Xing still remembers his first time watching the film.
好不容易搞到一张票，还是很后面的，很失落。但是看的呢，仍然是很吸引人的，因为跟大家有很强烈的一个共鸣。
Pan Xing had no idea that this film would change his life. After graduating, Pan went to work for the Central Newsreel and Documentary Studio. The person he most wanted to meet was Chen Guangzhong, who had directed Don't Let Time Slip Through Your Fingers.
就问同宿舍的，陈光中长什么样子啊？他说你要找陈光中很容易，穿花衬衫的。
The young person drinking coffee and this 1950 clip from his film Island Travels is Chen Guangzhong. Born in Hong Kong in 1930, at 19 Chen attended China's Huabei University and then joined Beijing Film Studio the same year to pursue his dream of filmmaking. His co-workers were skeptical.
不管是白眼也好，红眼也好，冷眼也好，我都不管，我做我自己爱做的事。Soon,
under the guidance of director Zhong Jianfei, Chen found an expressive outlet in the film Eternal Youth. The film used the mainstream athletic movement to express the spirit of modern people and the vigor of youth. However, the film was heavily criticized, and the entire film industry shook as anti-rightist campaigns took China by storm.
I think the students are always always fighting. I don't know how to say it, because at that time, our personal fate was never going to be 和那种时代那种漩涡也好，那种逆流也好，所对抗不可能太渺小了。After
10 years of turmoil, the pent-up emotions led to a new wave of cinema. Director Lu Xianhua's Scar and Liu Xinwu's Class Head submerged China in a sea of tears. Films like The Legend of Tianyuan Mountain and Wildlife Crisis tore open the wounds of human nature. By now, Chen Guangzhong was already middle-aged and knew that he needed to regain some of his lost youth.
越拍的厉害，跳的厉害，拍的十年了，压得太厉害，一下子喷发出来了。有一次我在路上一走，看那个白杨树，树的像那人的眼睛一样，很像各种各样的眼睛。我一想，这眼睛难道不是我们青年那种眼睛吗？是吧？时光的见证。青年他们有时候走这树也不知道啊，但这树里面，它等于是一种一个时间老人一样，注视着我们那些青年人。
人生的道路是这样的开始，生活的脚步是这样的开始。
当人生进入暮年的时候，啊，年轻的朋友，我现在真是羡慕你们，甚至有几分嫉妒。人的一生
，Don't let time slip through your fingers. Abandoned over-the-top voiceovers, and adopted an intimate second-person perspective, highlighting the individual instead of the collective.
小人物大命运，小人物大问题，小人物大矛盾，这正是我所想的。小人物可以也站在中国纪录片荧幕的中心角色。
For a long time, heroic archetypes were the most common conventions in Chinese cinema. But these bore little relation.To the lives of ordinary citizens.
告状信也到了刑场了，这挑动群众斗领导，用片没有配领导的，都小青年了，没有一个团员，没有一个党员，没有一个劳动模范，都是有缺点的。
With the official channels denying him support.Chen Guangzhong filmed under the cover of night, uncovering a unique cast of characters from Shanghai streets.
哎，同志，你不是演小字辈的张明明同志吗？
是啊。
你现在还在这儿体验生活呢？
我本来就是电车驾驶员嘛。
哦。
小鱼既不是马戏团的巡售员，本职工作又没有这个要求，但他大胆训练猩猩表演节目。让人们多一点笑声，多一点笑容，又是多么好！
不要这个人是谁？
陈喜德搞的太阳能高温炉，要用1000多块玻璃镜子组成，每一块镜框都要靠自己敲打出来。
Filming such individuals, the production team were labeled as Western capitalists.Chen Guangzhong didn't stop there. He included ordinary youth in his shots. Filming them wasn't easy. Cameraman Zhang Dao Guo still remembers the process.
We 事先呢，把这卡车的车棚呢，用了杉木给它遮挡起来，在侧面留了一个小洞，刚刚够一个摄影镜头。当时呢，拍摄时间是在七八月份。里边的气温度啊，估计在40度左右，所以你特别闷又不通风，在里边呢，一会儿的时间就大汗淋漓，那是浑身都湿透了。
Sound engineer Du Shuyin used a Nagra 4.2 recorder to record young people's thoughts.
怎样正确对待生活？
我想，如果说不红，那就是在讲假话了。
As each person spoke, it awakened a sense of self-realization.
我跟老陈光中导演说，我说我想啊，让每个主人公都要听听他的声音。
对，让弱者发声，弱势群体吧，对不对？让他们讲话。
我第一个是口吐的口。
But obtaining clear audio from live sound recordings wasn't an easy task.
我们的摄影机还是阿莱呢。这个机器啊，一开开以后，像电锯一样，声啊特响。那个我们当时就把那个棉袄啊，什么的被子啊，裹在摄影机上。
年轻的朋友啊，我们每个人都有着昨天、今天、明天。
This take is 2 minutes long. As the speaker's excitement grows, the lens slowly zooms in.
包含着歧路上的
This photograph shows Chen Guangzhong meeting with the recently rehabilitated director Zhong Dianfei at China's Golden Rooster Awards. Now in the twilight of his career, Zhong advocated using realism as a foundation for artistic expression. Other directors agreed, suggesting that Chinese filmmakers follow French film critic André Bazin's theories on realist cinema. Long takes, Bazin, and filming reality became buzzwords in the Chinese film industry.
我也没有进过电影学院嘛，是，因为那个对理论是很用即刻感，啊，总觉得很新鲜啊，什么新浪潮啊，这八点理论呢、啊，那个等等吧，反正是不断要充实自己嘛。
The combination of Bazin's long take theory.And French New Wave cinema's use of natural sound provided Chinese directors with a new direction. Director Zheng Dongtian's film Neighbors highlighted the use of natural sound to the audience, greatly enhancing the friction in the story.Huang Jianzhong's As You Like used natural lighting, with images of sunsets and shimmering water. Zhang Aixin's Spring Prayer used a long take of some swimmers to express a sense of beauty and freedom.Don't Let Time Slip Through Your Fingers also grew out of this era. Realism became Chinese cinema's new wave. But the biting cold remained in people's hearts. While this university dance scene appears happy, it actually expresses an intense internal struggle.
灯也架好了，然后也放音乐。结果呢，谁也不跳。我说华东师范大学的华东的这个师大的学生们，20世纪80年代的大学生，你们连个舞都不敢跳。你们毕业以后，怎么能够啊建设祖国、搞革命啊？我说响音乐，音乐一响，他就放音乐，放音乐一放音乐，这学生们看我的一鼓动呢，也都上去跳去了。
当时呢，我呢随着那个音乐的节拍呢，时而进，时而退，时而旋转，就很自然的一个长镜头就拍摄下来了。从视觉效果来看呢，那青年人呢翩翩的舞姿，展示了青春的这种美。
Chen believed that the youth naturally radiated spring.His use of long takes lingers with the young dancers to express such beauty. Decades earlier, direct expression of feminine beauty was forbidden in China. Earlier films like Red Detachment of Women expressed feminine beauty through a soldier's uniform. As restrictions relaxed, later films like Diving Women showed feminine beauty through its underwater scenes. Chen Guangzhong took beauty as his main theme, and he produced a trilogy of films expressing his perspectives on beauty. Including athleticism, colors, and nature. In him, youth was best expressed as love.
哎，明天我们局里要举行一次集体婚礼，再会上，还要我朗诵一首诗呢。那你给我念念吧。好吧。年轻的朋友，爱情的海洋里，唯有纯洁的风帆，真诚的罗盘，才能使幸福的航船永恒的驶向远方。
年轻的朋友。
Chen wrote the lyrics for the theme song in Don't Let Time Slip Through Your Fingers. Jin Fuzai wrote the melody. The song became a hit.
想像那个跳探戈舞一样，有钱有劲的，就不要那种一般化那种歌颂式的元素，也不要那种威武雄壮凯旋感那种金曲，而是一种抒情的，那种像。
抚摸着灵魂似的，做一个朋友一样，相伴奋进，一步步奋进。陈光宗对现实的思考，这种思考跟国家的命运结合在一起，那种浪漫主义，他的那种创造激情，在中国都强调共性的时候，他出现太有个性的一个。
In 2013, 32 years after the movie's premiere, Chen Guangzhong, now nearly 80, hurries to hear Xiao Dan play at a piano festival in Beijing.
Hello,
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 hello, hello, hello, hello, hello,
hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello, hello,
证明时代变化，我和当年我妈弹的曲子是一样的。音乐和诗让你更加美丽，更加多想像你妈妈一样。谢谢你，再见，拜拜。拜拜，谢谢。 Spring is a metaphor shared among many nations. For Chinese documentaries of the 1980s. Spring expresses an attitude of optimism towards life. The youth of that era have now entered middle age. Spring is behind them, but spring lives on eternally through their art. Were the red thumbprints real or fake? The debate continues to rage. A movie which was filmed to honor a hometown was banned in that very place. Films with synch sound could be produced in large numbers thanks to one powerful tool. Join us for the next part of China on Film 2.